Hello, veteran Owen Twin here. Welcome back, and this is another episode of Final Fantasy VI. In the last episode, we made it to the capital of Vector, and we began exploring the Magitek Research Facility. This place is one of my favorite areas in the game. I love it. Love the music, like the battles, like the atmosphere, like the surroundings, and I like kicking the shit out of Onion Knights. And yeah, I should, Guard Leader is probably the random battle rage of choice in this area. Unless, of course, he just does lousy physical attacks. If you do Flash, it's probably the best ability you can use in this place for group's enemies. Okay. Yeah, Celeste will gain a level very, very soon here. Then I can switch her back over to Kieran so she can finish learning the Cura spell. Ah, yeah. That's right. Actually, why don't I go this way first? Yeah, every time I do this place, I always get confused on which areas I want to go first and all that kind of stuff. That's alright. Aha, another area over there we can get to. Yeah, there's a door. Yeah, right below where I'm standing right here, there's actually a door that you can go through to get to some hidden chests. And, aha, there's a chest over here. Alright, we get a tent, and yeah, we need to do some backtracking here. Probably could have went either way, and it wouldn't have mattered. But it looks like I'm doing a little backtracking now, but that's fine. Whatever. No hurries. No hurry, no worries. We're all good to go. That wasn't enough to gain a level? Oh, it was. Okay, cool. So yeah, Celeste should have gained a magic point from that. Yep, she did. She was at 51 before. So let's switch her back over to this one so she can finish working on Kieran. And then when Gaw's going to gain a level, he should have Kate set equipped. And yeah, for Locke and Edgar, I mean, if I had a strength Esper, then I'd be giving it to them. But yeah, I don't care. I don't care about HP or stamina. Those are worthless stats to raise. Alright, but yeah, there is some treasure we can get down here, I believe, somewhere. Isn't there? Oh yeah, okay, you just gotta look up. Alright, we get some golden armor. And since the white dress is going to be better than that, yeah, it's gonna go to Edgar. A little bit better than a mithril vest. No, actually, it's quite a lot better than a mithril vest. But there you go. Yeah, don't give it to Celeste, because she'll lose magic power that she gets from the white dress. It is better defense than the white dress, but it is pretty negligible, so don't worry about it. And over here we get a golden helm, which is not better than a green beret. I'd rather have a green beret. It is better defense, but that's about it. And I guess I have everything in this area. I thought there might have been another hidden chest, but I guess not. Good stuff. Love it. Love it. I wish we could hear this theme for the rest of the game. Yeah, this battle will go quick, so I'll just keep it in. Oh yeah, by the way, those Onion Knights, they can self-destruct. Which, they only have like 250 HP, so it's not that bad, but that's probably the worst thing that they can actually do to you. Okay, we can't go this way. Damn it. Alright, so we have to do some backtracking now. This kind of sucks. Yeah, we can't actually do anything with this crane right there. Kinda looks like you can, but you can't. Alright, before we take that conveyor belt there, I'm gonna go this way first. Yeah, there's some secret passages and whoop over here. Okay, so we're gonna have to make our way down now, I believe. And yeah, I'll just throw this in here. I'll show this one. Yay, go out, gain a level. Probably gain some magic too, hopefully. Yeah, you want to raise his magic that way. Wind Slash and Giga Bolt are more effective. So I guess I'll give her this. That way she can start working on it again. Or when she gets a level, she'll get the bonus. And I'll have you work on Kieran some more. I suppose I could switch Siren over to Edgar. That way he can... Well, no, then he'll start learning spells. Yeah. Yeah, I don't want him to learn. I don't want him to learn any more spells than he has to. I want his spell list to be very limited for the monster arena or fucking what is it called? The Coliseum later on. Oh yeah, for this battle I should use Runic. Come on, get your fucking Runic off. Now it's probably worthless. These guys will probably be dead before. Can even take advantage of it now. Yeah, see? What the hell, man? Yeah, enemies drop a lot of magic points in this area. Alright, we get an Ice Brand, which is essentially the same thing as the Flame Tongue and the Thunder Blade, except it is, well, it's Ice Elemental. So there you go. And we get a Zephyr Cloak, one of my favorite accessories, or relics. This one is pretty good. Yeah, I think I'll replace the sniper eye with it. Yeah, cloak inhabited by the spirit of a wind sprite. Boosts evasion and magic evasion. So yeah, it's really good. So I'll give that to Locke for now. Because that'll boost his already very high evasion. Yeah, we just end up right back over here. Of course, I gotta get attacked before I get on the conveyor belt. Oops. Yeah, sadly, Flash cannot one-shot these guys. The only thing that sucks. Well, maybe if I gave him, well, actually, no. I already have a hero ring on him. So that should raise his magic damage a little bit. Uh-oh. The Warring Triad? What the hell is a Warring Triad? I like how he just throws them around. Yeah, this is that is the best villain in Final Fantasy history. He is awesome. And I love how Duel Magus in Dragon Quest VIII is kind of like a... I don't know if he's supposed to be an homage to Kefka from this game, but he seems like it to me. Anyways, if we come over here... if we jump up and touch that crane, I think it'll take us back up if we want. And we have a new enemy against a Flan. And as far as I know, they can absorb... I can't remember what these guys can absorb. Okay, Wind Slash does not work. Obviously. Blast works, though. Alright. Yeah, I don't want to touch that crane and go back up, but we can come in here and save our game, which I kind of need to do. This last save I did was a quick save. Wow, what the hell, man? I was just trying to say hi to you. Why are you fighting us? Holy cow. But yeah, we're gonna have to fight these two. And they don't have any items. I'm not gonna bother with rages in this fight. But I am gonna use Blizzard spells on Aoife here. Ooh, ow. That is gonna hurt. Yeah, actually, I'll use a drill on them. So that'll ignore defense. And this guy has really high defense. Ooh, ow. Jerk. I sense the kindred spirit. Who are you? You have Rama's power? Wait. We're Espers. What, you don't have to fight Shiva at all? For some reason I was thinking you had to also fight Shiva, but I guess not. Why don't you try and live? You should try to live. You shouldn't try to die. Really? We obtain the Ifrit Magisite and the Shiva Magisite. So let's take a look at him. Now Ifrit has strength plus one, which is pretty good. You can learn the Fire, Fira, and Drain spells. I don't know why you can learn all the, like, Rasp and Osmos with Shiva, but those are really good spells to learn. You can learn Blizzard and Blizzara. However, this Esper does not have any bonuses. Oh yeah, and by the way, I'll be showing off the Esper special attacks, you know, later on. Because yeah, if a character has an Esper equipped, they can actually use, like, a special attack, like in Shiva's case, Diamond Dust. Which, to be honest with you, they're not very useful. Some of them are useful, but most of them aren't. But yeah, I'll be showing them off later on. Alright, this seems like a good time to actually look at the bestiary. So See if I can view any new ones. Looks like we have a bunch of new ones. Yeah, I can steal high potions from those guys. Weak against fire. These guys are a pain in the ass. Weak against ice, huh? Gee, I didn't know that. I have to remember that the next time I play. I never knew that. See, I'm learning all kinds of things about this game. Bear steals a sleeping bag from these frickin' Livewire chickens. Weak against ice. Good amount of status immunities, too. Rare steals a green beret. Not that really matters. I mean, hell, green berets are pretty easy to find. Magicite shards, potions. Yeah, good status immunity. Yeah, this enemy here, number 39, we definitely want to encounter. We encounter that guy in this place somewhere. And number 36, where the hell do we see him? Oh, well, it don't matter. But we definitely want to encounter him, because number 39 here, because we can... Well, he's a good enemy to encounter. You can get a good rage from him. You can learn blue magic from him later on the vault. It's going to be pretty essential encounter. All right, anybody else? Okay. Oh, you can rare steal tiger masks from those dons. Very interesting. I actually ended up rare stealing dragoon boots from those wyverns, though. I remember that. And these guys... I did rare steal a mithril vest off-screen. You didn't see that. But I did do it. Anybody else? Yeah, mithril mail you can steal from these proto-armors. Any new bosses? Ultros again, second version, I guess. Yeah, I fucking annihilated him the second time around. He was a joke. Yeah, especially since he's weak against lightning, you know, with the Gigavolt ability. Pretty much one-shot them. Yeah, and these bosses are really nothing. I mean, it's more of a event battle than anything, scripted battle. So whatever. I think that's it. All right, that's all for this episode of Final Fantasy VI. In the next episode, we will continue exploring the Magitek Research Facility. This is Veteran 0121. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.